When this place opened in 1939, it only held 7,500 people. 70 years later, it holds nearly 12 times that. We're live at Jordan-Hare Stadium in Auburn, Alabama. Hello, everyone. I'm Brad Nessler, and beside me in the booth is Kirk Herbstreit. Erin Andrews is also with us. She'll be reporting from the sidelines. Today's presentation of college football is brought to you by Spark, because better athletes make better football players. Our game features the Alabama Crimson Tide and the Auburn Tigers. Heated rivalries in all of college football. For Auburn, they've got the difficult task of dealing with a very heady linebacker today.
To put it simply, this guy is the general of this defense. His teammates look to him for leadership and to make plays, and he gets the job done.
Now let's take you down to midfield for the coin toss, presented by Spark, because better athletes make better football players. Both teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. For Auburn, is there anything we should be keeping an eye on?
With this spread attack, they like to have four or five wide receivers on the field at once. They get the quarterback in the shotgun and give him a lot of room to make decisions. He'll have to get good protection from his line to make things work, though. That'll bring up second and
12. From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Well, I think it's safe to say the defense had his number on that one. It can be very frustrating for a running back when he's stopped before he even gets going.
From their own 21-yard line, it's third down. Back to pass. He's going to air it long. This one is batted away.
Super effort to get the ball and knock it away. Real good job down the field.
So it's fourth down. They come out in a punt formation. Oh, man, he took him down hard. So he got a little on that return.
Well, Brad, early it looked like there was an opening there, but the seam closed quickly.
And out comes the offense. Nice run up the middle. Richardson picks up about 4 yards on the play. From the 50, second down. They'll run the option. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line. McCarron gains around 3 yards on the option play. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. It's absolutely deafening down there. McCarron, options out to the right. He's brought down in the open field.
There's a reason why defenses hate playing against teams that run the option well. It's so unpredictable. That time they couldn't defend it properly, and they gave up a first down.
From the 37-yard line, first down. Inside give. The 10. He's finally tackled at the 5-yard line.
A run like that usually ignites the offense. So let's see if they can stay on a roll.
First and goal from the 4, looking for Pater. There's the handoff. He scores. So the halfback took it in for 6.
Simple play call there by the offensive coordinator. Just give it to the back and let him find his way into the end zone.
Converts the extra point. It was a 5-play, 53-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. It can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
So the score now, 7-0. Alabama kicked this one off. Tackle made at the 41-yard line. This drive will start at the 41. First down, 10 to go. Knocked down, incomplete.
There's just so much going on down there in the trenches. It's really impressive to see a guy get off his block and perfectly time the quarterback's release.
Dyer, the ball carrier. He gets out to about the 42-yard line. He may have changed things up here. They give it to the running back, and not much there.
Good, solid defense there to force him into a fourth down situation.
That'll make it fourth and 10.
It's fourth down. The punter comes on the field, getting ready to send one off. Taken down at the 28-yard line.
With this field position and a good scoring opportunity, they might try to strike quickly to take the crowd out of the game.
This offense really ran the ball well as they finished off their last drive with a touchdown. Catches it. They'll bring him down at the 31. 3 yards there on the play.
Usually you get a linebacker covering the tight end, so they might want to try some longer passes to exploit that mismatch.
He's looking for his man. And he got it! And he's brought down at the 11. Perfect time for the play-action pass.
Well, here the defense is looking for the run, and the play-action put him in even a worse position. They just weren't ready for the pass there.
It's first down on the 11 going in. They go with the option. And they make the stop at the 2-yard line. Unselfish play by the quarterback as the option gives them a 9-yard gain. It's second down, and they're only 6 feet away from 6 points. Looking for Peter, found it, touchdown. The halfback just plowed his way into the end zone.
Yeah, but it wasn't all him. The offensive lineman just pancaked the defense on that one.
And he converts the extra point. So a four-play, 72-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
So the score now, 14-0. Alabama to kick. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. The offense will start at the 29-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Gets a block on the corner. Has a man, he'll lose big yards. Drop back 4 yards on that one.
Well, that play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Dyer gets the call. He makes his way out to about the 35. He caught some key blocks and was able to turn it into a 10-yard gain. Here's the back, nowhere to go. And that was a nice stretch for the D there.
Yeah, they really cranked it up a notch on that series.
Oh, excellent punt. Tackle made at the 29-yard line. He did a good job there to give his team decent field position. They'll take over at the 29. Off to the right. Gains his way to the 49-yard line.
Some guys are dangerous no matter where they are on the field. Whether they have speed, elusiveness, great vision, whatever the case may be, you have to find ways to get the ball in their hands.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 49. Here's a handoff up the middle and no room to run. Richardson picks up 2 yards with a carry. From the 49-yard line, second down. And it falls incomplete. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. And this crowd is going crazy. Throws complete, and he's got space to work. And he scores! Touchdown! Good start in the passing game. That's 100 yards already.
And the defense better make some early adjustments, because if they keep getting beat like this through the air, this is going to be a long game for them.
PAT, a four-play, 70-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
He'll return it from the three. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. They'll start at the 26. the give. Nice run there. They're changing the play. He makes his way to about the 38.
Even if you're pulling for the other team, you've got to just admire this guy's speed. He is special.
He's changing things up. Throws to the fullback. They can't hook up. Incomplete.
Taylor is the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 38. Catches it. Tackle made at the 39-yard line. They got a little bit there, but less than a yard.
Nice grab there by the tailback to at least move the ball forward for some positive yards.
They're changing the play. Throws it, and oh, he dropped it.
This unit has quick hands, and they showed it there by knocking away the pass.
It's fourth down. They come out in a punt formation. He's out to the 30. Gets to about the 37-yard line. Not a bad return. They'll set up shop at the 37-yard line. At the 30. There he goes. And he will score.
Well, everything's clicking right now. This is one of those games coaches dream of. There's still a lot of football left, but right now, these guys are steamrolling through.
And this one's turning ugly, and we've only played one. Our score here at Jordan-Hare, the Crimson Tide, 28. The Tigers, nothing. Alabama gets set to kick this one away.
Number 23, ready to return.
He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. The offense will start at the 30-yard line, first and 10. Dyer, the ball carrier. Here he goes. Inside the 30. The 10. And he's all the way in for the touchdown.
Just a great effort there. Once he had some space, off to the races.
I think there's a young guy over there on the sideline who's still wondering how he didn't make that tackle. Tacks on the extra point. Clark looks ready to kick this one off. From the 5-yard line. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. They'll get the ball here at the 27-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Richardson takes the give. Richardson gets about 4 yards on the draw play.
That makes it second and six.
Second and six. Ball on the 31. He'll get it again. He's on the run. At the 30. To the 20. To the 10. And a huge touchdown play. That's his third trip to the end zone.
You've heard the saying, a guy's in a zone. Right now, this guy's not stopping for anybody.
PAT, a short two-play, 73-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. So our score, 35-7. Alabama is ready to kick it away. Taken at the 5. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. This drive will start at the 28. We've got a first and 10. Takes a handoff inside and stopped immediately. Dyer comes away with about 2 yards on a little draw play.
The defense called the blitz at the right time, and they were able to come after the running back before he went for big yards.
Option. He fights forward to about the 30. A yard, if that, on the quarterback keeper.
Well, this corner isn't the biggest guy on the field, but he made a nice tackle there.
He may have changed things up here. And he's going to throw. He's out of bounds, incomplete.
Too bad that'll go down as an incompletion because he made a really great play on the ball to make the catch.
He's to the 40. He makes it to the 45-yard line. This back's had a good day on the ground, Kirk.
Well, he has, but let's also give some credit to the offensive line. Doing a tremendous job of pushing the defensive line back to give the running back some room to work with. And really, all this kid needs is just a little bit of daylight, and he's a threat to take it to the house every touch.
You know he's relishing sticking it to these guys, and I'm sure he'll get a chance to torment them some more. This drive will start at the 45-yard line. Alabama is winning big. It's complete, and he's immediately tackled. A pickup of 5.
Not a bad play. They gain 5 yards out of it, and they keep moving the defense back.
They'll make the sack. It's the senior corner who nails the quarterback for the sack.
Nice call here, but they might want to wait a while before going back to it again.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. Back to pass. Going long. Picked off by the senior. And he hits him hard at the 3-yard line. And that interception might be what they needed to get back in this ball game.
Nice try, Brad. Keep their hopes up, but I don't think they have a chance of winning this. They're too far down to catch up.
This is a dangerous situation, backed up against their goal line. Ball on the 3-yard line. He gets out to about the 14-yard line. That one got him out of some danger.
The offense caught a break there. Great run by this guy to get him out of the face of their own end zone.
He may have changed things up here. They'll drop him for a loss. So the halfback loses about 2 on the run.
That'll bring up 2nd and 12. Trotter is in at quarterback.
From their own 12-yard line, it's 2nd down. Cut. finds his way to the 33-yard line.
They've obviously found a formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
Nice run, and he's brought down. Big hit, and he'll lose yardage.
Did you see how that big defensive line got such a good push on that play? That's exactly why they were able to stop him for a loss.
From their own 33-yard line, third down. Looks to pass. Pressure coming. He's right there for the interception. The ball pops free, and he is drilled at the 34.
What can you say if you're on this offense? You're already chasing these guys, and now you've got to give them the ball back. Not the way you want to get back into this game.
The offense will start at the 34-yard line. We've got a first and 10. And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down. So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
On the ground with the tailback. He might have a chance inside the 30. And he's finally taken down at the 11. That last run puts him over 200 yards on the ground. This is some game he's having.
What you like is how clever he is at allowing the play to take shape before he makes his move. That shows vision and maturity.
McCarron looking to throw on first down. Throws it, and oh, he dropped it. They're really fortunate that wasn't intercepted.
Not a very smart decision by the quarterback. He had no shot at completing it.
Drops back to pass. End zone pass. Oh, almost picked off. That ball had interception written all over it, but the defender couldn't hang on.
I think the quarterback there was a little too intent on hitting that receiver.
McCarron drops to throw.
Man, this is tough going for this quarterback. Next time out, he needs to just relax. Think back to all those practices and not worry about what's happened in this game up to now.
Kicks up, and the field goal is good. Alabama to kick. They'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. They'll start at the 28. We've got a first and 10. They'll run the option. Nice run there. They get about four on that keeper. That makes it 7-6. The offense calls a timeout, and they'll have two remaining. Looking to throw. And he's tackled right away. They get about 7 yards on the pass and pick up a first down.
And how about the poise of this quarterback to locate his receiver past the sticks and get him the ball? That was a great throw.
That's what the defensive back coach likes to see, his kids reacting when the ball is in the air and then making the play.
Back to pass. and he's going to be sacked.
You know what happened there? The offensive line was so focused on picking up the blitz, they forgot about blocking the defensive lineman.
It's third and 11. Ball on their own 38. Dyer on the inside handoff. It's on the ground. He's taken down at the 46-yard line.
Offside. Home defense.
Looks like they got a little too anxious trying to jump the snap count.
Third and six. Ball on the 43. Back pass, and they couldn't hook up on that one. He sailed that one high.
That's not a bad incompletion because he saw the blitz coming and just got rid of the ball to avoid losing yardage.
Tackle made at the 24-yard line. They were lucky to prevent a big return there.
Yep, that could have been big if he could have gotten a few more blocks and was able to find the seam.
I'm really surprised how lopsided this first half has been. But this is college football, and no matter what the score is, the adrenaline's always pumping on both sides. Very good tackle in space. The Crimson Tide call a timeout, and that was their first timeout. Short over the middle. Tackle at the 48-yard line.
Calling a screen will sometimes slow down the pass rush. So if you're playing a team that likes to blitz a lot, this is one way to get them out of that.
He looks to throw on first down. It's caught. Touchdown, Crimson Tide. Nicely designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him six.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator.
It was a pretty simple route, but they run it to perfection for the score. The PAT. It was a quick three-play, 76-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
The score now, 45-7. Oh, man, did he take a hit. They'll go to work at the 30. Big hit there to stop him. Couple of yards at most on that pass.
This junior wide receiver had absolutely no room to run after the catch. Good play by the defense.
Looks to pass. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. That's a great tackle at the 48.
Good pickup here on the ground, but I bet the coach would have been happier if he was able to get out of bounds on that play to stop the clock.
And he's sacked. He may have changed things up here. Drops back to pass. And he can't get away from the pressure. Pretty impressive pass rush right there.
These hits take a toll on a quarterback, physically and psychologically. The blockers have got to do a better job of taking care of him.
Wants to go long and does. Incomplete.
You definitely want to give your receiver some room to run under the ball, but not that much.
Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there and one of his guys can come down with it. Looks to pass. Here comes the pressure. And they sack him on fourth down. And we finally come to the end of the first half, and this one's not even close. Our score here at Jordan-Hare, Alabama 45, Auburn 7. We're all ready for another half of football, even though this game is already out of hand. Taken at the 5. He makes it to the 28-yard line. For Alabama, they played a whale of a game so far. They've really taken control. For more, let's send it down to Aaron.
Brad, this is definitely not the type of game we thought we'd have, and seeing the faces of those guys on the losing side just emphasizes how far off it is. They look upset, they're involved in heated discussions, and this is after they had time to think about that first half. And for Auburn, they've only gotten to the quarterback once, and that's something the coach pointed out. He'd like to see them get more pressure. Back up to you, Brad.
And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
That is exactly the type of play that good linebackers make on a regular basis. And if you can make enough of them in college, you're probably going to get a chance to play at the next level.
Hands it to the back. Gains his way to the 40-yard line.
That's a gain of 13 on the play. First down.
From their own 40-yard line. First down. McCarron looking to throw on first down. Throws incomplete.
They got lucky on that play. That receiver was wide open, but the quarterback just missed him.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40-yard line. Here's the run. Got a hole. Here he goes. To the 20. To the 10. He scores. What a play. That is his fourth touchdown on the ground, and this has been quite a game for him.
We wondered if the linebackers were going to be able to slow him down today, and I guess that answer is pretty simple. No.
And he adds the extra point. A four-play, 73-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. So our score, 52-7. Alabama to kick. He's to the 10. They'll bring him down at the 28. The offense will take over at the 28-yard line. First down, 10 to go. They go with the option. And he tackles him hard at the 40.
You love having this kind of weapon. You already know what kind of damage he can cause in the passing game. And here you can see what he can do when you hand the ball off to him.
Throws a strike over the middle. And they make the stop at the 48-yard line. They're changing the play. Hand off, and he's met immediately. Dyer only gets about a yard there on the draw.
Really just nowhere to go on that play. It's a good job of these guys slowing down that running game.
Up the middle for a nice game. And they convert the first down on that run.
And the key to that play is a good blocking up front by the Hog Mollies.
He's changing things up. And he's taken down at the 35-yard line. He may have changed things up here. Blake on the run. Nice run to the outside. So they go on the ground and pick up another first down.
They are stringing together a nice little drive here. If they keep this up, it'll be hard to keep them out of the end zone.
Here's the give. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. They'll spread the field with five wide. They're calling an audible. And it's caught. Brought down at the 13. And that's what we were talking about earlier.
Absolutely. Nice pass play here. The quarterback shows some guts here, throwing this one into coverage, but good accuracy and, again, great timing on the throw.
Option left. He tackles him for a loss.
You've got to admire the intensity that these linebackers bring to the table. As soon as he saw it was staying on the ground, he made a beeline for the ball carrier.
From the 16-yard line, second down. Got him on the screenplay. He's tackled at the 12. The screen is good for four.
I like the play call here. Getting to the receiver on the screen, he had blockers in front, and he turned the play into a nice little game.
There's a fumble. Big opening. And this offense continues to impress.
Defensive touchdowns give teams such a big morale lift. This was a really nice play to grab the loose ball and take it the distance.
And he tacks on the extra point. Alabama is ready to kick it away. He gets out to about the 32-yard line. For Alabama, they've been getting into the backfield quite a bit.
You know, all week long, the defensive coordinator for this team told us that it was a major priority to put pressure on the quarterback, and that's exactly what they're doing.
And for the Tigers, they're not only struggling in the pass protection department, they're struggling to get yards.
As you look at these hits, one of the things that can be tough for a quarterback is you start to worry more about the pressure than actually reading the defense and looking downfield and trying to find the open man. You start to get happy feet and panic, and right now that might be setting in on this quarterback.
They give to the tailback. And he's tackled at the 43-yard line.
I thought it was pretty impressive they were able to stop him. I thought he had enough room to break away from everybody and take it all the way to the house.
Tackled after a decent pickup. Off and he's met immediately.
You know, a lot of times coaches look to linebackers for leadership on defense. And on that tackle, he showed you why that's the case.
He may have changed things up here. Dyer gets the call again. Gains his way to the 19-yard line. He got the first down and much more.
I'll tell you what, this guy is a threat every single time he touches the ball.
He's changing things up. Level at the 14. He must not have seen anybody open on that play.
Nobody open downfield, but he's got to be careful. I like his toughness, but those kind of hits are going to take a toll on him eventually.
Pitches it, and he'll lose yardage.
They need to get back to some hard-nosed north and south running and try not to get to the outside so much. The defense just has too much speed for that.
We've got third and 10. Ball on the 19. He's looking to pass.
This is incomplete. Part of the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it fourth and 10.
So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. The holder's on the 26. This will be about a 36-yarder. And he got it. Auburn to kick. Taken down at the 36-yard line.
Kickoff returns 29 yards.
They'll start at the 36. It's first and 10. The pitch out, and he's got a block around the corner. He's got an opening. Inside the 30. The 10. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown. He's been hogging the spotlight all game long with his 5 runs for touchdowns.
We're witnessing a truly amazing performance by this young man.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Alabama gets set to kick this one away. He's to the 10. He's tackled at the 30. They'll go to work at the 30-yard line. Gives it to the back. Nice run to the outside. He may have changed things up here. They go with a run, and he's brought down in the backfield.
The D-line did a good job of nullifying out the blocks up front, and that allowed the linebacker to roam free and make the tackle in the backfield.
From their own 32-yard line, it's third down. Got him on the screenplay. Tackle made at the 43-yard line.
That is money in the bank. Sometimes you just can't stop a good combination.
Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. And they lose a couple there.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
Over the middle to his tailback. At the 30. To the 20. And they finally knock him out at the 10-yard line.
You've got to bring him to the ground as soon as he touches the ball, because if he gets those afterburners on, he can easily take it to the house.
He's changing things up. Run play, and he'll lose yards.
The defense was playing run all the way right there, and it paid off for him.
That'll bring up second and 11.
Not much of a contest here as we head into the final stanza. Our score here at Jordan-Hare, Alabama 66, Auburn 10. Second down from the 11-yard line. Dyer again. Well, they're not going to win it, but they're still playing hard out there.
He is such a talented, skillful back, as you saw right there. What makes him even better is that these coaches know how to use him.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. A nice 7-play, 69-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. So the score now, 66-17. Clark looks ready to kick this one off. Richardson fields it at the 2. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. They'll set up shop at the 25-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Little handoff. He's finally tackled at the 49-yard line.
When you combine his speed as a runner with the strength of the offensive line, you have the potential for some long runs.
From the 49-yard line, it's first down. He launches one for the end zone. Knocks it down.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 49-yard line, second down. Give to the tailback. He gets to about the 41-yard line. Lacey gains 8 yards on that play. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Toss sweep. He looks for the corner. He fights forward to about the 39.
They played it pretty carefully, going with the run in a short yardage situation, and it paid off.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 39. McCarron, back to pass. And he's taken down at the 35.
Good coverage by the defense, but they have to be aware of this quarterback's tendency to scramble around and pick up some yards.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
First and 10, ball on the 29. McCarron with the option. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
First down, threatening inside the 10. Norwood takes a handoff. He's in. Another touchdown. It's been one touchdown after another all game long.
Everything just fell into place out there, and nothing was going to stop these guys from getting the ball into the end zone many, many times.
And he converts the extra point. It was an 8-play, 74-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Well, the blocking up front was just amazing. I think that's what led them to those big runs.
Alabama yet set to kick this one away. Gets to about the 27-yard line. They'll start at the 27-yard line. First down, looking to throw. Throws it, and oh, he dropped it.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception, only to be dropped.
Looks like an option here. At the 40, at the 30. He goes down at the 25-yard line.
They picked a good time to go with that call. Didn't seem like the defense was ready for it. They'll move the chains.
Throws to the fullback. They can't hook up. Incomplete. Well, he didn't lead him enough on that pass.
He tried a little too much finesse on that pass, I think. He needs to get a little bit more velocity on it. That way, you don't have to lead the receiver so much.
Sure, they won't win it, but they haven't quit yet.
Wow. Could you see that end zone in front of you? It can elevate your running to another level. Awesome play.
Converts the extra point. A four-play, 73-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. So the score now, 73-24. And it's the kicking team that's got it.
It doesn't look like they're going to be able to pull this one out, but you admire the hustle to recover the onside kick, even at this point in the game.
Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Finds his man, first down. And they bring him down at the 37-yard line. Drops to throw, no protection. They got in there in a hurry.
They've really thrown the quarterback's rhythm off and rattled his confidence with such a relentless pass rush. He's not himself out there at all today.
Dyer on the counter, right side. Gains his way to the 30-yard line. They're showing blitz. There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
Dead ball. One start on the offense.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 27. And this one's broken up.
Anytime you can prevent a third down conversion, you're doing something right. Solid coverage.
It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. He airs it out. Throws it, and it's caught for the touchdown. Kurt, that was a beautiful pass and a nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly, and again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
You've always got to be on your toes when you're covering this guy. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Get the ball here at the 34-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Richardson takes a handoff. Good outside run there. Richardson picks up about 7 yards on the run.
That'll bring up second and three.
From the 27-yard line, it's second down. And they'll run him again. And now he's got room to run. They get on the board again. Touchdown. Great looking play by the offense as the halfback took it in for the score.
Here's a play that was well designed and well executed. It can't get much better than that.
He makes the PAT. A quick two-play, 34-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. So our score, 80-31. Alabama gets set to kick this one away. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. From their own 27-yard line, it's first down. Tackled for a loss.
The offense knows that the linebackers are cheating up a little bit on the run. If they can get some protection, they might want to open up a little bit of space for some passes underneath.
Stopped behind the line.
The entire defense just collapsed on that run and got penetration into the backfield. Nice job by the safety to clean up the mess.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
It's fourth down. Here comes the punter looking to boot this one away. Whoa, he just took a licking. Nice yardage on the run back. We'll see if they can capitalize on the good field position. Fights forward to about the 49. And the halfback's got nowhere to go. From the 49-yard line, it's second down. Just under 2 minutes in the game. The play clock's at double zero. They just took too long.
Dead ball. Delay of game. On the offense. Still second down.
So it's second and 14. Ball on the 46. Nice run up the middle. Richardson gets 7 yards on the play. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 40. A little over a minute in the game. McCarron, back to pass. And he's tackled at the 35-yard line.
He's a big target that the quarterback can rely on. That's a smart play looking to him to get the first.
They come out in a goal line set. Richardson gets the carry. Has some daylight to the 10. and he will score.
You love to have a home run threat like him in the backfield. Every time he touches the ball, he's capable of tearing one off like that.
So they had their chances to stop him, but in the end, he comes up with a big play. Converts the extra point. So a four-play, 49-yard drive. And they put up 7 points. So our score, 87-31. Alabama is ready to kick it away. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. They'll start at the 27. First down, 10 to go. Drops back on first down. Can this offense do anything to slow down this pass rush?
I think they need to make some adjustments with their pass protection. Maybe allow the backs to stay in the block because the quarterback is getting pounded back there.
From their own 24-yard line, second down. And that should do it. Our final tally in this one, Alabama 87, Auburn 31.